now try to walk you through the wiring of the squeeze to brake, guys. The first wire is for the 3.3 volts, which is the power supply of the sensor. The second wire, which is over here, is for the ground. And the third and fourth wire is for the analog inputs. Now, at the end of this wiring is where the barometric pressure is located. Made a little hole from the inside of the lid, and then I pushed the wires through, and finally I applied the mastic just to make sure that it's completely airtight. Now, this diagram over here explains in simple terms how the sensor is connected to the Arduino. Now let's look at the Arduino code. Include libraries and define the altitude, which is 35 meters. Create an object called pressure. Start communicating with the computer at the rate 9.6K. Connect the sensor and print line if it does connect correctly. If it doesn't, then print line error connecting. Declare our variables, start the temperature, and wait for the measurement to complete. This line over here returns 1 if it's successful and 0 if it's failure. Here we actually get the temperature readings, we start the pressure, and finally we get the pressure. Convert the double B to an integer, because processing doesn't like doubles and I had some difficulties getting the actual measurements from the Arduino to processing. And finally subtract 900 from the raw value from the sensor, and finally serial write the variable and push it over to processing. Now I'm going to quickly talk about the processing code. Here we import libraries, create a new object called myPort. This is the actual values from the Arduino. Declare minimum objects, sound, songs, diameters, and a counter. This line over here assigns my port to COM3 and specifies the speed. Creating new objects, loading files, songs. These over here specify these ellipses. This over here, if the my port is available and is more than 0, then just read it and store it in this variable. Now here, if the value is more than 110 and less than 80, then the diameter, set diameter to 70, which is this, exactly this. Now if it's pressed even harder, then the diameter expands quicker. Over here, if the diameter is in between these values, then the song starts and adds 1 to the counter. Now if it's in between these values, it just pauses, and it's basically uses the same principle for each of these loops.